looking for?
I'm looking for the blue M30s. People call them the perks, but I believe they're fentanyl. Anyway, I'll be here. I'm a homeless man. Hi, excuse me, bud.
Every person watching will own NFTs, all of you. You're gonna have to. Every airline ticket's gonna be an NFT. Every sporting event ticket. Why is that a QR code? It used to be a physical ticket, remember? Now you scan that shit. It's going to be an NFT.
Got the answers. You ain't got the answers, Sway.
Kanye.
I've been doing this more than you.
Doing what
you ain't
more
got
than me?
Come on, you ain't got the answers. You ain't got the answers.
You
ain't been doing the education.
Bro,
you ain't been doing the education. You don't have the answers though. Because you trying to give me advice about something.
No,
you ain't got the answers. You ain't spent $13 million of your own money trying to empower yourself.
Damn criminals running this country. Fuck them. Fuck them. I'm sick of their shit. Fuck these motherfuckers. See, I gotta go to rebroadcast. Go.
I wouldn't want to be fucking trannies, not knocking anybody that does, yeah. But like, I could definitely see, like, because when I'll fuck girls and they're not supposed to be fucking me, they'll get so much more turned on, like,
you fucking accuser, get the fuck out of here, you fucking accuser, you motherfucking accuser, get the fuck out of here,
wow,
you motherfucking accuser, accuser of the fucking brethren, you motherfucker,
like, I wanted to fuck one girl, fuck her really good, and then fuck a different girl, and then fuck a different girl, and we could come back to this girl or this girl, but like there had to be somebody in between. Like for me, it was always just like the different, and I would forget what it was like to fuck this girl after I'd fucked, you know, a decent amount of girls, because I don't know, it's just like, it was, you know, you wait it long enough and it's just like new. So I never really, like,
she says taints.
All right,
she calls it taints, and she's
an S plural.
Yeah,
taints.
Yeah, like you're like a bunch of
taint,
men,
and you, we have taints.
You know, we individual have a taint.
Taint,
two
no,
of us have
taint, no.
There's three taints in this room.
We are.
I'm assuming
we're tainted up.
I'm so bullish on NFTs. Stupid bullish. Especially now. Like, I've literally devoted my life to this shit. Like, literally 100%. Because, like, the more I got into the space, the more I realized the practical application of NFTs will make this like a mainstay in culture.
I swallow every piece of gum.
What?
I've swallowed every piece of gum that I've ever chewed in my life.
I currently own 9 CryptoPunks, like 6 apes. My shit is definitely not floor shit. I got some fucking money.
How much money do you think you've made in the last year off of NFTs?
I would say conservatively, not made, not like liquid, like a modest number, probably like 7-8 million. And if I really
radio guy, don't act up with the radio guy.
I hate my nigga. Y'all finished or y'all done? I ain't got no more talk.
Welcome to War Mode.
It's Bob Saget here, and this is for the apes. I don't know if you have the same apes that I've been seeing on the Twitter, but it's been blowing up. So if you're those apes, I salute you. Holy Toledo, it's Bob Saget, and you are all degenerates. I know that because you're the apes. That would make you degenerates. And I just wanted to...
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no?
No.
All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
All right, recording.
We're good.
I don't have to hit anything.
No, pause.
All right, sweet.
So when did you start the Turn Up Tiki stuff?
Probably
we got Pill and we got Joe. We'll leave it at that. Pill is a Turn Up Tiki boy. Joe's Joe. Joe's
Turned Up Tikis.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
NFTs.
Joe's just a vaccinated guy who has to come on the cast.
Just staying safe.
Yeah, so Tiki's Turn Up Tiki's Solana project, we got started like mid-August, we started going balls deep into the NFTs. Probably started the project in like September, beginning of September. So we've been on about a 6-month grind for the Tikis here. But we minted, meaning launched, like end of November.
What the fuck made you do it?
Dude, like I've been doing crypto shit for like 5 years. So when a new wave comes, I dive headfirst into that shit. I want to learn about it. So I'm a nerd with that shit. So I wanted to learn about it. So I was like, started like trading them and like buying them. And at first was like, wait, what is this? This is stupid. Like just an image. This is autistic. And then quickly I was like, oh, you can make like a business out of this. So me being entrepreneurial, I was like, yeah, we got to do our own project. So that's kind of what made me start doing it.
What'd you start with crypto? What was it?
Like early 2017, I just bought like Bitcoin and Ethereum and then started like learning about it. They call it going down the rabbit hole. So I was deep down the rabbit hole. similar to like being deep down the Jones rabbit hole. I went deep down the crypto rabbit hole.
Didn't you say you were on Jones in 2016 though?
I was listening to some Jones. Yeah.
He had his golden years. 2016 was probably the best year of Jones.
I mean, he was calling for mass vaccinations and shit, so he's pretty on point.
Yeah, he did call all that. But yeah, so you did. When did you get into crypto, and then what you do? You just peaced out the fucking Utah. Was that a?
I mean, I've been doing this shit for 5 years. So what I did was made money in 2017. Was on a high. Lost a fuck ton between 2018 and 19, like everyone else that held through the bear market. And then made it back again when it started going up again.
Right now, the Giuliano, he was on the last time. Oh, absolutely cucked out one answer. Spade had
I lost it all, boys.
He had all the AMC stock, and fucking the owner of AMC just was like, yeah, we're selling our shit, but if you want an NFT, like, we'll give you one.
Wait, so what happened with AMC? And Spade, you actually bought it?
I mean, Giuliano told me to do it. I don't know anything about this stuff. He said it was a good idea, and he got me all hyped on it. And then now today, I couldn't hold anymore because I can't afford to lose any money. So
is it down like a large percentage? Like, what's the deal?
It went down a lot from what it used to be.
Gotcha. You got to buy more.
I was like, this is just going to keep going down.
Buy more.
So I'm trying to shift into something else.
Yeah, they say there's a saying in crypto, buy the fucking dip. So...
Do you fuck with stocks at all, or is it just crypto?
I mean, you're supposed to, right? But I obviously don't care. But fuck that. That's boomer shit to me. I just want all crypto. And then when I'm 35, I'll either have a lot and I'll be able to do what I want, or I'll be at McDonald's flipping patties. So I'm willing to take that risk.
What'd you buy AMC at?
I can't remember. I can look on my phone.
He was doing all right.
7%.
I was killing it for a while, man. I was killing it for a while. The last 6 months have been hard. Pretty much ever since Giuliano came on, it's been down. I really want to talk to him too, and he's not picking up the phone.
Is he still buying? On the pod, he said he was buying every day. Every day it's down, he buys.
Yeah, I don't know. But what's the deal with like NFTs and stuff? I was watching a video and they were saying that like you can hold it. Like, what's the deal with like staking all that stuff? Is that actually real? Like, if you stake at 12%, how the fuck does that make sense?
So basically, I don't know if you've interacted with crypto at all yet, but how it works.
None.
So on a computer, not on a phone, on a computer, you have a wallet as a browser extension. So like if you're using Google Chrome, you'll have a browser extension. You click it and then you send yourself crypto. In this case, Solana is like what I've been using a lot lately because that's what my project's based on. And then you can go into a marketplace and buy an NFT, and then it puts it into that wallet. And in terms of staking, like staking means the people that made the project allow you to basically post your NFT to their website, and then they give you back tokens as a reward. And these tokens make you like passive income because people speculate on like the price of the token, which adds liquidity to the market. So like in theory, you're making money by holding an image. This is all like early stuff. So like how long that lasts, I don't know, like in terms of like people making money, just staking NFTs. Some of them you don't have to stake. You just keep it in your wallet and it just pumps you out tokens.
Pause.
And then, obviously, pause. Whenever the word pump comes up, we'll throw a pause. So yeah, if you are earning these tokens and they're quote unquote pumping, you can sell them for some money and get like US dollar coins back. So then you're making money. So that's kind of how that works.
I don't understand like how, like you started this and like what's the whole process of making them? Like, is it easy or what the fuck do you do?
So it's pretty easy for technical people that are like familiar with working with like code and the command line and getting up like local environments. I don't know, that might be foreign language, but like if you have some mild technical skills, it's pretty easy to create an NFT. Yeah. You even on some like exchanges, you don't even need to do any code related to things. You can just upload the image, which is more practical for most people. But yeah, it's actually pretty easy for like technical people.
So who was your squad on Turn Up Tiki's though?
We, me, someone, you know, I'll call him Dylan. We'll leave out the last name. Dylan, good friend of mine. We worked on a startup before for like 3 years. And then lead dev was this guy out of France, who we met literally on Discord. Like in the crypto world, you meet all these people on Discord. You don't even know their real names and shit. You just like know their like pseudonymities, like fake names. And they actually end up being like really like competent people that you can work with. So yeah, that's how we got the lead dev. And now we work with a guy, I'll leave out his name as well, but he's a CTO of a company. He's like pretty big in the tech space and he like does a lot of our marketing materials. We also met him through Discord. So it's basically like us four and then another developer we just recently brought in. So we basically have a team of five with like three founding members.
And then
how'd you get the Discord following? Sorry, bro.
That's a good question. No, that's real important, honestly, to like the success of NFT projects is getting people in your Discord. Bill and Spade can speak to this because they have a lot of people in their Discord, but
we never made it. People just made it, like we didn't do any of it.
They made it for you?
Yeah, other people make all those things.
That's hilarious. Yeah,
we're like legitimately tech illiterate. It's fucking like uncomfortable almost.
I mean, well, so to answer your question, like if you have a following like Bill and Spade do, people will join your Discord because it's a place for them to talk with like-minded individuals about whatever the fuck. For NFT like startups, you basically have to do collaborations with other projects. Through Discord, which basically brings people from that community that you did a partnership with to join your Discord. So kind of like pause your members in the Discord. So yeah, that's kind of how you do it with a new NFT project.
Yeah, this shit, it's just absolutely foreign to me because like we were thinking about doing like Spade stuff, but like we had no idea how to actually like go about it. Like, can you just draw it on a fucking iPad in a minute?
Yeah, so for you guys, like not being the most technical, Spade could do his drawings. You can release as many of them as you'd like. Maybe Spade will do 100 of them per se. You can upload them just as like you're uploading an image to an email, super easy. And then they'll be on chain, whether that's Solana or Ethereum. And then you can sell them for X amount that you decide. And then those 100 that are now in existence and the people that bought them for X amount of dollars, you'd have to reward them with some sort of exclusivity. So like maybe you guys do a third hour every week and only those 100 people can access the third hour. You can do like a verified Discord channel that actually verifies that the people in your Discord are the ones that hold the NFT. And then they'll be the only ones allowed in a Discord channel where you post the link for like the third hour of war mode. So that's like something you guys could do.
Is it just like a money grab when like Gary Vaynerchuk puts up like a fucking retarded doodle picture and says it's an NFT? Like, is that guy a fraud?
So when he did, so no, he's not a fraud. To answer the question, so
that's your boy.
Not my boy. He's a little too eccentric. He's a little too eccentric for my taste. But
all right, he's your boy.
I'm more of an Anon, but he's not doing money grab. There's fuck tons of money grabs though. Let's not get it twisted. That's without question.
Is Gunna doing a money grab currently?
Who?
Gunna, the rapper, is doing NFTs.
I mean, dude, we talked to a marketing team that offered to get us celebrities and they gave us a whole spreadsheet of celebrities and what they cost to promote their NFTs. Like, Gunna probably got a bag to promote that. He probably got 100 grand. They probably gave him 100 grand just to promote that. But yeah, like you're going to see like all these celebrities promoting projects that a lot of them will be money grabs, yes. But then again, some people actually like buying it. Like they like buying a fucking Pokemon card. So
yeah.
But yeah, there's definitely money grab aspects without question. Gary Vee's pretty legit though. He's like building a long-term project with long-term vision. So I wouldn't put him in the money grab category. He's already rich as fuck anyway. He doesn't need to do NFTs.
Yeah, that dude just rubs me the wrong fucking way.
Yeah. He knows how to act like all uppity on fucking camera and shit. Like he's good at that shit. I'm not, but
what about like go ahead, Joe.
What's the end goal of like the project? Because I feel like most people say to have it in like their NFT in the metaverse, like a 3D form of it.
Joe's trying to buy land, by the way.
No, that's a great question.
I'm trying to get land in the sandbox. Bonus just hit. I'm trying to get some land.
Yeah, dude. Buy some land in the sandbox. Buy some land in Decentraland.
What the fuck is a sandbox, though?
It's basically like we're in a Google Meet right now. So imagine instead of us being on camera.
Just a bro down.
Yeah, just a bro down. Imagine us being on camera. We were just like four tikis or four whatever.
Nah, that's good. Yeah, be something else.
Yeah, you could be a dildo. Yeah. Bill will be a dildo. Spade will be a vibrator, pocket size. And you guys can kind of like.
I'm but an egg.
You guys could like walk around as your avatar in the metaverse and like talk to other people like we're talking now.
But this shit isn't. Your boy Zuckerberg's metaverse. This is a different metaverse.
Yes,
very different. Zuckerberg, the dude you love.
Yeah. Zuckerberg, pussy. So basically, the metaverse thing is this: there's going to be Facebook's version, which they'll probably try to do like business applications, like having meetings in the metaverse. Talking to like your Aunt Susie, who's 85, who doesn't know how to like make a cup of coffee, let alone get into the metaverse. But for some reason, I'll try to promote it to her. But no, then there's like the decentralized metaverses, which are being built. They're not really built yet, but they're like in the process of that. And that'll be on like the blockchains such as Ethereum and Solana, and others, but those two are kind of the biggest right now. But that gives like, so if you're in the metaverse and you have like a bedroom and you have like a bed and like whatever else, a lamp, those items will likely be NFTs. So like you actually own the property in your metaverse instead of like Facebook owning it. So that's kind of like the two angles that it's coming from. But back to like what Joe was saying, long-term goal, like for Tiki's, we're just trying to make people passive income right now, which we're succeeding at. We have a token called Tut, which trades. How many Tiki's you own gives you an X amount of Tut, which you can then sell or keep, up to you. But long-term goal, yeah, we're trying to make a game now. We're working with other like metaverse companies or startups in the Solana world that are actually building metaverses, and the Tiki's will be able to be used inside their metaverses. The word metaverse is really like a fucking buzzword, honestly. Like this is early software stuff. Like none of the stuff looks that great yet. Like it's very early.
So like if Joe has a dream of owning a plot of land in the sandbox, now his thing is he wants to just put a poker table there. How hard would it be to make a blackjack table in the sandbox where you can just have people come up and play blackjack?
So that's very realistic. Gotcha.
I was reading that like everybody's just doing like art studios and just hosting, like then you could sell, like people could rent a spot in your land and then put their NFTs up in your like art studio and for sale or whatever. And that's what I was like, no, it's gotta be a casino. You gotta get some land and just start a casino.
No, you're on it. You're on it. Honestly, the casino stuff's blowing up on Solana right now.
The fuck do you do that though? Like how does that work? Like how the fuck do you buy land there? And then you're like, this is a blackjack table. Like, do you have to code that?
So some of these metaverses have items you can like drag and drop, like you're dragging an image or something that you're used to doing. You can like drag and drop like a poker table, and then you can post a link, and then maybe the link will take you outside of the metaverse and like to an actual like blackjack online thing that's already built out, because like there's so many degen online gamblers already. So you just kind of use that existing like gambling infrastructure, but you just throw it into the metaverse so people can like walk up to the table and like meet someone and then fucking be like, yo, you want to play blackjack? And yeah, so that stuff's being built. Actually, it's a good use case in the US. The gambling shit, like, you're playing with fire if you want to get in the gambling world, because it's basically illegal in the US. So it's we'll see how it is, but like, it's a really good use case for crypto is gambling, because like, it works. You connect your wallet, you bet a certain amount, and then it gives you that crypto back if you win. So there'll be cool apps now, built on that.
Like, is that shit gonna fuck up money though? So like, if you have your tuts and stuff like that, and someone else has like a casino and it's all their own currency, like, is that why like all the governments and shit spurg out and like China made it illegal to fucking have crypto?
There's like a lot of reasons why the governments in certain countries would want to make crypto illegal. It depends what country you're talking about, but gambling in general is not legal in the US. You would just have to set up like your shit in like the Bahamas or something, which people I guess are doing. Yeah. We're not really involved in the gambling stuff, but in terms of like countries banning it, like China has banned crypto. Why would they do that? Well, because they don't want their fucking citizens to have control of money. They'd rather the Communist Party have control of money, obviously. So yeah, quickly banned. The US is not going to ban it, actually, and they've said that point blank, which is smart, because it'll lead to like wealth creation for this industry, so that's good. However, the US has a lot of reason not to want like Bitcoin per se to be the top like cryptocurrency, and for it to gain like mass adoption in the country, because obviously we have a lot of power with the dollar being the reserve currency. So that's also a bit of a quagmire for them. So we'll see how it plays out. I don't really think it's too close right now where Bitcoin's used for everyday transactions. Like, there's a lot of technical reasons why Bitcoin can't be used for everyday transactions, but it makes for a really good like store of value, like a gold competitor. So that's more of like the Bitcoin use case, is like a store of value like gold, with more upside than gold, because it's still like 1/10 the market cap of gold. So if you think the digital version is going to pass gold, then you still got like a 10x from here, so you should get yourself some.
Speed, what was that shit Giuliano was telling you, like the American government made Bitcoin or something like that?
Yeah, something like that. I can't remember. We need him here.
Yeah,
he can't remember what he was saying. He came out with a crazy thing where I was like, holy shit, that might be real.
Yeah, I've heard that rumor. I would call fake news on that.
Mike just texted me. What a fucking pussy.
Finally, motherfucker.
Hold on. Let's see what he says.
Get him in here.
Last second edition.
Can you hear me right now? I don't know if I muted myself.
I could hear you.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, send him the email. Hold on. I'll tell him Pill's emailing him. What a fucking cuck, dude. Yeah, but what the
I have heard that they're gonna let Bitcoin and all these other coins run wild so that they work out all the kinks, so that eventually they'll just swap it out for the central bank digital currency system, which is coming. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's definitely something that's being talked about. The US is definitely building theirs, their central bank digital currency. China's like made really good progress, way more than the US on theirs. But there's a lot of inefficiencies with the traditional banking world. Like, you guys have probably done like bank transfers from one account to the next. That shit takes like 3 to 5 business days. Like, who's got time for that in 2022? Like, no one. So if you were to do like a dollar stable coin on Solana and do payments for like dollars, you can create a lot of efficiencies in terms of like payment rails that don't really exist now. Cause like the banking systems run on some old ass like Cobalt type bullshit where it's like 1920s type shit. So
yeah, this the main thing I feel like everyone's doing with this stuff though is just they're just laundering money. Like, is that all? Like, it seems like it's just all like OG Wayfair human trafficking, like buying retarded rock NFTs for $1 million.
Yeah, so there's definitely some money laundering going on. I don't have proof that that's happening. That's the rumor. But anytime you see people buying a weird ass rock for like $1.5 million, you start thinking, wait, is that the Mexican cartel doing that? Or like, is that like an actual person? Like,
It's no sense.
What if the cartel just gets real tech savvy, just real fast?
I mean, they should. I mean, Bitcoin's actually not really anonymous, but instead of packing fucking 10 million into a Suburban, you can just send it over the chain. It's a lot easier.
So yeah, how does that stuff work? If they're all, if it's all like they were using it for like the Silk Road and shit back then when you were buying Molly, how does all that stuff work? Like if it's all tracked, like every fucking dollar, how do they not catch you?
It's, it comes, it's like the government can use their powers to catch anyone doing anything. Essentially, it just becomes how big of a, how big of a whale are you in the ocean? Like if they want to catch you doing something, they very easily can. So yes, if you do a massive Bitcoin transaction, it's all on chain. Your direct name's not tied to it, but your wallet address is. So yeah, they can see what, if they've tracked you down as like the Mexican cartel's stash of Bitcoin and they've got like 10,000 Bitcoins, they can see what wallet has it and they can like see where it moves from there, but they'd have a big problem confiscating it. How are they going to confiscate it? They can't. So there's confiscation proof with crypto, which is different than like slinging fucking $100 bills, which you can just take out of the duffel bag. So
yeah. Yeah, the Silk Road was some sketchy shit. I'm almost positive I did meth instead of Molly when I went to Made America, and I was just toasted. I've never felt so bad in my entire life.
Yeah,
Silk Road. I feel like meth would feel like an XR Adderall, 30 milligram XR.
No, this shit was not cool at all. I did Molly two times. One time there, and the other time in Seattle City. I think that's when Joy. I think you were with us, Joy or Pilla.
When
you texted my cousin Pat's ex-girlfriend at the time, she just broke up. They just broke up. Pilla texted this chick's mom, "I'ma suck your fat ass bonkers."
I don't remember this, but would I believe it? Yes. That sounds like something I would do at an adolescent age. Yeah.
Oh, when did you move out of Philly? Because weren't you going rogue? Like you broke your face a little while ago.
Yeah, I did. I moved out of Philly in November 2020, November 1st.
You were going rogue though.
In what way?
Weren't you just fucking going rogue every weekend? I feel like I remember you like going in and like fucking like perusing certain buildings in Philadelphia.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm definitely rogue by nature. That's for sure. Yeah, I mean, going rogue. Yes, I was just, I mean, I wouldn't necessarily call it going rogue. I would call it like being entrepreneurial. I never really was trying to work for some fucking company for too long. So, yeah, I was kind of going to the beat of my own drum, I would say. Yeah.
So you went out to Utah, right?
Yeah.
And then at what point did you do like LSD and fucking have this? You said you did LSD and then what?
Oh, I did LSD in college. Temple, like final year before I like quit Temple.
Did you?
Yeah, I you know the person. I'll first names only, but Marcus.
Chill, dude.
Yeah,
Wampus.
Wampus had okay. He was taking LSD like our senior year at Temple, and he kept saying like, "Yeah, you gotta try this shit," and I was like, "All right, dude, nah, I'm not trying that shit." And then one night I got like real drunk, and I like broke into his room, and I took the LSD. And it was fucking amazing. And then, you know, you try it again after that. And, yeah, you have some positive benefits that you weren't necessarily expecting, I would say.
Yeah. How do you like living out in Utah now?
It's cool. I could ski, like, whenever, which is dope. I like to ski. It's, like, a cool outdoor activity when I'm not grilled to the screen like a cuck. So that's nice.
How many hours a day were you working on the NFT?
Oh, many.
You have a bald spot in the back of your head still or no?
Obviously. When do bald spots come back?
Well, you picked it away. I don't know if it would grow the fuck back.
Yeah, yeah, I did. That OCD, yeah, a little bit. Less than I used to, for sure. Less than I used to.
That was all fueled by Grand Theft Auto, though.
It was probably fueled by autism, yeah.
Yeah, so, like, what's the next step after you do this NFT? Are you going to make another one or... What's the deal with all that shit?
So we're not going to make another one in the short term. We're going to work on making this one as best as it possibly can be. Longer term, I mean, definitely looking to do like crypto related companies for sure. And if NFTs are an avenue to do that, without question, would explore that. But there's a lot of cool startup ideas you can take with NFTs and with crypto in general that could be real successful. So yeah, eventually like spin off into like an illegal entity that's like registered in the US and shit, and try to like make an actual entity that has value versus like a decentralized project. So yeah, we'll definitely look into that for sure.
What's the deal? Like if someone right now, like if Joe wanted to go from all stocks to fucking all crypto, what would you do? Because I'm trying to get out of USDs, dude. That shit's for fucking pussies. So I don't trust the dollar at all. I think the fucking world's going to collapse every other day.
It's tough to say. I mean, I think the dollar is fine now, because if anyone tries to question the dollar's reserve currency status, what will we do? Start fucking war, obviously. So like, we've got the war machine. So I mean, I don't see that being a big threat. However, they are printing that dollar at a rate that's sickening to savers, because it just inflates it. So like, Bitcoin can be good for that. How you would go about it is you would connect, if you have like $100,000 in a checking account or whatever, and you want to buy that. Whatever. I'm just giving numbers. if you have $20,000 in a checking account and you want to
hypothetically, if you had $700,
Cum Rocket is your coin for $700. Hope that thing moons.
You didn't like Bitcrash, Bill said.
No, was that? Was that the horse? No, what was
it?
It
was a rocket.
The rocket
was the rocket. Sometimes the 100x, sometimes the 0x.
I mean, all this shit is the metaverse to me, dude. Like right now, we're in the metaverse. I don't know what's going on. I want real stuff. You guys in the room.
Yeah, I mean, I absolutely I absolutely shit the bed last time you were supposed to do this. I allegedly got coronavirus, never took a test, so I don't know for sure. It could have been just a cold. But yeah, you were coming to the house. This would have been a normal podcast, but I dropped the ball.
Hey, man, that shit happens.
Yeah, it happens.
You might have to get the vax, bro.
Nah, obviously, I just won't do that.
Nah, you need it.
And now,
is there a value on that, Bill? How much would you need to be paid to get the vax?
You couldn't pay me.
There's a number, dude.
There's obviously a number.
There's a number, dude.
I could not take it.
$5 million.
Dude, I don't know. Like, I literally like, I think it's gonna fucking kill me. Spade, what would you do it for?
Oh, I wouldn't. You guys are gonna get cancer in like 5 years.
Yeah.
Dude, you're gonna get it. We're all gonna get it anyway.
Yes, smoking like a double vax cuck, dude.
We're all gonna be living in the metaverse, dying on the universe. It'll be tight.
I don't know if I can come to the metaverse, man. I might have to peace out at that point.
There's gonna be robots taking care of our bodies, but we're gonna be living, balling out in the metaverse.
Yeah, Spade, you can have a Playboy mansion.
I'm good, man. This is depressing enough.
Yeah.
No, Spade, you're right though. Like saying we're already in the metaverse. Like some people will be like, I'll never interact with the metaverse, blah, blah, blah. It's like, dude, you won't stare at a screen for 16 hours a day. You're already doing that shit.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm a peasant, dude. This sounds cool that you're getting all this money. Hypothetically, if you had $2,059, what would you do?
I mean,
I still think Spade could make his NFTs. Because Spade's an actual artist. Not like,
and supposedly, I never drew on a computer though. You know
how hard is it to draw on an iPad?
I don't know.
Frank's got the programs for that shit.
Yeah, you can draw whatever, Spade. Like you have fans, real fans. So what you draw, they'll value, and then just give them something of value for giving you their money for that NFT. Like it's very realistic for you guys.
Yeah, then Spade, you could become a multi-thousandaire.
Yeah, well, Billy's telling me there's these guys that are just living off of NFTs, and they don't even have to work. Like, he's telling me this while I'm choking on dust, covered in drywall dust. Like, oh, yeah. Dude, there's guys making 2 G's just chilling every day. I'm like, what the fuck am I doing?
Yeah, like, you can trade them.
That and, like, O'Connor playing video games. This is the shit that's happening on my phone.
Yeah, you can trade them, and you can make money for sure. The thing with crypto is all that stuff comes in boom and bust cycles. Whenever something new comes, it has the boom, and there will be the inevitable bust at some point. That's just kind of how it goes.
Like, is this shit, like, if you pay attention to it, though, does it become easy as fuck?
I mean, no. you gotta work just, fucking long put, hours. Yeah. Like I'm not gonna sit here and act like crypto's a 30 like hours a week thing. Like it's not, it's more of like a 70 to 80 hours a week thing, and it moves so fast. And if you wanna like stay up on the curve, you gotta be grinding on the screen, which gets real depressing at times. So that's a good thing for being in Utah. Get the fuck outside when the screen's starting to give you anxiety and shit.
Yeah, that would, that's the only problem that would drive me insane. Like that's the only reason, like I would like to do the shit, but to look at a screen all day long, I'd literally go insane.
Yeah, it's at that point, it's not worth what the money that could be made. I mean, yeah, you have to put in a ton of hours though, like to answer that question.
Yeah, so we're just fucking peasants for the rest of our lives.
Not necessarily. You guys can make like some dope construct some sort of contractor business.
Chill with that. Yeah, a regular business. But the land stuff, I just don't understand the metaverse. Like the whole blockchain thing makes no sense to me. Everyone just says the blockchain. It's like this shit I'm hearing with the Eagles game, the flex. Like everyone's been saying the flex all week long. Zero clue. Never heard that in my life. Spade to back me up on that. He's also the fuck is flex, dude. They just keep saying the game's flex. I've never heard that in my fucking life.
I don't know what that means. So
that's what I'm saying. And everyone just acting like it's a normal thing that the game was flexed. That's fucking a problem I have.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know shit about the sport. I'm not paying attention to sports these days too much.
What is the blockchain?
So in regular technology, like when you have money in a bank account, it's in a database. So it says like your name and how much money's in there. The blockchain at its simplest and most fundamental like form is another way of doing a database. So in terms of money transfer, it just tracks like a wallet ID, which is just a bunch of strings of random like letters and numbers, and then what amount that you have. And it's a new way of doing databases. Instead of them being quote unquote centralized, like hosted in Amazon servers, they're hosted on like a bunch of different computers around the world that anyone can set up. So like you can set one up as being part of like the database network for the blockchain, and you get like money for doing that. So that's kind of how it works. Does that make sense? Probably not, but does it?
No, not at all.
Yeah.
So it just makes it harder. Like, isn't hacking like a horrible thing that happens constantly with that, all your shit?
With crypto?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, not if you know what you're doing, you don't get hacked, but like new people that come into the space and they keep their coins in like their browser extension, and then they click on the wrong link, and then they connect their wallet. That website they click on has actually been built to just drain their wallet. So like people get hit with that all the time.
My God.
Oh my God. So now, is this dark web shit?
It's not.
Dude, that shit can happen with like Venmo too. Like my Cash App got hacked. I woke up to my phone buzzing. It was just like -$250, -$250, -$250. And it didn't stop until I canceled my Cash App.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Insane, dude. That's good though, because you get like customer support gets you your money back and stuff. In crypto, like if you get hacked, you're done. Like there's no customer support. True. Like there's smart ways to go about it. Like you keep your coins offline and like a thing that looks like a USB, which can't be hacked. So like if you have like 50 grand in crypto and you keep like 45 grand offline, that's like very safe, because like that 45 can't get tricked into accidentally giving it to a scammer.
This is the shit where people lose in dumps and stuff.
Yeah, then they like they'll have that USB with the money on it, and they'll like lose the password. Yeah, that happens. There's like smart ways to go about this. The thing is, which will be a problem for like crypto mass adoption, is that it's hard to teach these new skills to like new entrants into the space. Like it takes time to learn, and you got to get fucking scammed a few times. They call it getting rugged in crypto. Rugged. So you're gonna get rugged.
Have you got times. Rugged?
Oh yeah, I've been rugged.
Are they rugging tuts?
No, they're not rugging tuts, but like you'll go to like mint a new project, and the founders just set it up so that it just drains your wallet for whatever's in it.
Didn't that just happen with some movie? Or no, like wasn't there a meta coin that was just a complete like fake, not real, and they just robbed everyone? There was like a metaverse coin.
Yeah, dude, it happens every single day, unfortunately. It's one of the downsides of like not
having. If you wanted to, how would you set this up?
I mean, you make a fake website. Well, it's not necessarily a fake website, a real website, and you say you're going to do such with the project, and then people give you your money, and then you just delete the website and go to fucking Panama.
Joe.
Are you going to be able to die in the metaverse? I was just thinking about, like, when I get on the sticks in GTA, when you're passing the controller around, like, first thing I'm doing is running over a couple people.
Absolutely, yeah.
Is that what the metaverse is going to be like? Some what's the move? What's the show called? They're all robots. Westworld. Are you just like killing people?
I'm not sure, yeah, man. That shit's like, it's still early days for the quote unquote metaverse. I don't even like using that term too much because it's owned by Facebook and they're going to get like copyright on that shit. But for the online digital world, it's early, man. Like,
do you chill on it?
Fuck no. I'm a boomer.
You've never been on?
Shit's for nerds.
I stare at a screen 16 hours a day, like 6 days a week as it is, because I'm from work. I don't want any more of that. I want less. So,
do you own an Oculus?
Fuck no. I won't buy an Oculus. That shit's for the Gen Zers.
Facebook owns that too.
I'm a boomer with that shit. I'm not buying that shit.
So you're just all on the computer?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. So are you like, would you buy Sandbox stuff or no?
I would. It's a bit expensive, honestly. Like, I'm not about to buy a plot of like metaverse land for like 10 grand. I don't know. That's a bit expensive, but like, it might go up in value. I have no idea.
What'd you say?
I said, whatever.
Joe's got like 10 plots on the Sandbox.
Yeah. I'll be chilling next to Snoop.
Yeah.
Snoop plots land.
I feel like. 450 grand?
Snoop's neighbor just bought land in the Sandbox next to him. I think they said 450K. Pretty sure. Yeah. I'll check it right now.
Yeah, I mean, dude, this shit has to just be money laundering. Like, there's no way that makes a lick of sense.
Well, there's a lot of crypto rich people that got in early. Like, when Ethereum launched, it was like 20 cents.
Did you get an Ethereum bag?
Bag?
Yes.
I have a bag, yes.
From Ethereum?
A bag of Ethereum, yes.
But like, you got like, did that boost you up in your crypto world? Like, what's your hardest dub on your cryptos?
Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Solana. I got in early on all this, but I haven't really sold. I just kind of keep it. I'm gonna see where it goes.
Yeah.
Keep grinding, obviously.
Yeah, I need to fucking put some money into it, one that's gonna go up. I need one that's a dog shit coin. Like, do you fuck with the Shiba or anything like that?
Yeah.
Are you just an absolute homo about that?
Purpose. Dude, the Shiba things, like, answer your question, no, I don't fuck with those. I look for, like, legit projects. Legit projects that are not known yet, which is hard to come by. You come by, like, one every, like, 2 or 3 years. But if I find the next, I'll reach out.
But, like, how come you don't like Shiba? Like, that's just easy money.
I mean, it goes up and down a lot. I don't know, man. I'm not, like... Awesome.
Every crypto, though.
Yeah, Shiba. I don't know, man. I'm not into the meme dog coins. Not my thing.
Like, so all the shit. What, Joe?
Getting rich, like, as a joke, would be fucking hilarious, though. Like, if Shiba just, if you have, say, you have 60 million Shiba, and that just gets to a penny, you're chilling.
Yeah, so that's a big.
Ask you how you made money? You say Shiba, off Shiba. That's so goat.
So it is goat. For it to go to a penny, you got to look at like the number of coins existing. So if there's like 100 trillion coins, it going to a penny is like not realistic, because that would mean it would have like 5 times the market cap of Bitcoin, which is not happening. So you got to look at market cap. That's how you can like see a cheap coin. But like, there's so many dog coins that probably have like $5 million market caps. If you buy the right one now and it goes to a billion, you just made a fuck ton of money. So it's possible.
Yeah. Well, who's the main person you listen to? Are you at this point, you're just doing all your own shit?
In terms of like, where do I learn?
Yeah.
Like,
is it on YouTube or is this shit like deplatformed?
No, it's not deplatformed. So in 2017, when the bull run happened, actually it did get deplatformed. Like, crypto stuff, Google took it down, Facebook took it down. They're not doing that anymore this time around. Who I listen to, though, there's a guy named Balaji Srinivasan, who's ex chief technology officer of Coinbase, and he's just been in crypto for a while, but he talks more about like the
political. Bill showed me him.
Yeah, he's got a high IQ. I would listen to him. Definitely recommend it.
I showed you
him? Yeah.
Who is he?
That you showed me a podcast with that dude. I told you that he's Kendall.
Oh, the dude, the dude. He looks like Kendall Roy from Secession.
Yeah,
just a more Indian version.
I don't know about Secession, but Balaji Srinivasan, smart dude. He like he talks about like the future implications of crypto, where it's going, like the geopolitical implications, and he's got all that shit pretty like well thought out. So he's a good person to listen to. I'm more on that kind of spectrum than like watching the YouTubers that make those like autistic faces in the thumbnail. Like I'm not into that type of shit where they're like, buy this fucking dog coin, it's gonna 10x in a month. Like I don't really do any of that, but I like those dudes that like come with the philosophy side of things, like Balaji Srinivasan.
Yeah, that the stuff they talk about, just it's too high IQ for me. I cannot understand it at all.
It's deep, bro. Yeah, it gets very deep. Like, I'll listen to that dude's podcast once and I'm like, what did I just listen to? I gotta listen to this shit again.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems like if this shit can actually happen, like, there's that one Spade. Who's that black dude that does all the mushrooms?
Yeah, I know who you're talking about.
There's Kalani something.
Yeah, I don't know how to say his name.
Yeah, this dude's claiming that Bitcoin is like the fucking
36 grams wet.
Yeah, he eats 36 wet grams of mushrooms, and he claims that Bitcoin is like the money of the universe.
I mean, that's a possibility without question. That's a possibility.
Yeah, all this stuff, like it seems interesting, but it seems almost impossible to fuck with. Like, how long did it take you to actually start like figuring out what the fuck you were doing?
Long, probably like 4 months. Of like grinding, like of like
so nothing, short, dude. That's nothing.
I mean, so I'm talking short. 4 months of like Adderall prescription, up for like 20 hours, sleep for like six, repeat. Adderall,
so a regular person, that'd probably be like a year.
Yeah,
maybe. Yeah, yeah. But yeah, there's a lot of concepts to understand.
You're still on the Adderall?
No.
Did you hear that, Joe?
Gave that up years ago.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't. That shit is so fucking bad for you, dude. I used to do when we were at Temple. I used to do it, and I would have Adderall, a pack of cigarettes, and fucking coffee.
Yeah.
And now I have like heart palpitations constantly.
Yeah, I don't. Adderall's good the first 2 years, and then you start becoming a crackhead, like scumbag, and then you should put it down.
Yeah, but you're a productive crackhead.
You are. No, I mean, crackhead. You are. I wouldn't tell anyone that likes it to stop taking it. I would say keep taking it. But for me, I started having the negative side effects where like you just don't like smile and shit. So I was like, all right, enough of that.
Jesus.
Like you go into it, like I don't understand how. Would you do it like every day?
Yes.
How?
Now, how did you get started taking it?
Friends were using it. I tried it. I was like, damn, this shit's nice. This shit's
okay. It wasn't like a prescription when you're a little type thing.
No, thank God. No, hell no. I would not give that shit to a 5-year-old. I'd give them 5 vaxes though. I'd boost them every quarter.
Yeah, but, so now, yeah, when did you start taking it? Temple?
Yeah, probably like sophomore year, Temple. Yeah.
And how long did you like take it for?
Three years? Nah, 2 years. 2 years. Yeah.
What does that feel like year two? Like, do you even feel like you're on Earth anymore?
Dude, you'll be like,
like yeah. Seriously, like when I take it, I would try to go to sleep. I wanted to die. Like I couldn't stop thinking about random thoughts that had no connection whatsoever.
A lot of staring. Dude, it makes your mind. Yeah, it makes your mind like, for sure.
Just stare at the lights.
Yeah, like I'd be having a conversation with someone and like I would be thinking about like what I read about crypto like 2 hours ago, and this person would be like trying to like have fun with me or whatever, and I'd just be like not into it at all, like not into like your personality kind of goes out the window.
Yeah, you become a fucking robot.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you doing anything else now, or is it just fucking pure willpower?
No, I mean, I drink coffee. That's about it. No, I don't do any like pharmaceuticals now.
Yeah, that's big of you. Even though you did take both vaccines.
I have 2 of them.
Now, like, at this point, looking back on it, do you kind of be like, all right, you fucking got me?
No, the part was like, oh, you fucking got me. It was when they tried to introduce me to the third, the fourth, the fifth, the 97th. I'm not interested in that.
So you're calling it quits after this one?
Yes.
Even if your president tells you to get another one?
Antonio Brown. I'll just go Antonio Brown.
Yeah, I mean, that shit must be brutal and fucking all the tech stuff with – like, is that hard to, like, navigate those waters and, like, be fucking somewhat normal? I feel like I would slip up if I was in any sort of tech environment or workspace.
Dude, I just – there's so many fucking pussies. I just – it's absurd, honestly, the pussies. But I just – I just collect and then move forward. I don't really give a shit what they're on.
Do you never slip up? I find that hard to believe.
Nah. I keep my mouth shut. I don't really give a fuck what these people are saying. I find them all stupid. So,
yeah, that seems like a fucking a different universe than what I'm used to.
Yeah, definitely. You're used to like tough dudes. Oh fuck,
pause.
big pause.
Yeah, that
you're used to rugged Kensington burly men. Pause.
All right, chill. Yeah, that whole thing. It seems like. Hopefully, like with all the cryptocurrency stuff, a lot of this stuff will, like all the wars and stuff like that, may help stop all the fucking nonsense that's going on. That's my only hope with cryptocurrency. Like, you want to have like actual fucking wars going on over like retarded pipelines.
That's definitely a real possibility because like the war machines are controlled by the fiat currency machines. So yeah, that's definitely a possibility. It's going to be interesting to see how it plays. It's not going to be like an overnight thing. Like, oh, everyone uses crypto now. Like that was fast. Like it's going to take time because there's skeptics. There's people that don't want to deal with it. There's government cucks that want to remain government cucks till they die. Like that's just the way it's going to be. So,
what about your boys like Peter Schiff and them? They just say get gold. Bitcoin's absolute like fraud shit.
Schiff's an interesting character. I mean, I used to listen to this stuff. I listened to it like three times like years ago, and I used to think he was smart, and then he would just repeat the same shit over and over again, and I was like, all right, I'm just wasting time listening to this dude. But dude, if you look at Bitcoin versus gold, I mean, the numbers speak for themselves. Gold's pretty flat. Bitcoin's just not flat, so there's not really.
Yeah, but hasn't it been around for a lot longer? Like, I feel like, yeah, no one knows who invented Bitcoin, right?
It's yes, correct. No one knows. There's speculation. So, you could probably narrow it down to like five people.
But. Who do you think it is? Because I feel like that's an absolute trap, dude. To get all your fucking money, like Spade, wasn't that something you were telling me about? They were like trying to get like you like with Bitcoin and cryptocurrency, just get you on a digital wallet, and then they just fucking own you.
Well, I mean, they kind of own you either way, but. Once you start using digital currencies like this, they're monitoring everything. It's way more surveillance than it is with a cash system.
Yeah, there was like a video saying like they're literally just working out the kinks with us fucking mongoloids.
Yeah,
and then 10 years from now, that you're just fucked.
That's big facts, honestly. Like Spade, what you said is big facts. Like how it's gonna work in China, they'll introduce their digital currency, and then. They'll allow some people to save and like retire, but they'll also like, they'll know how to just keep you enslaved long enough to keep producing output based on how much money.
Yeah, they can change like the prices of things too, whenever they want. So like if everybody thinks they're getting rich, they'll just make things more expensive. Like we worry about inflation now, but like, you know, if they're like, oh wow, people have way too much money right now, they'll just raise the prices of everything. It'll always be supply and demand against the Bitcoins. You know what I mean?
So, yes.
Like, you're never really going to get rich. Like, if everybody in the country started having Bitcoins, everything would just be expensive. It'll just be a way for them to monitor what you do.
Yeah, so I was speaking more to, like, the central bank digital currencies in terms of the monitoring. Bitcoins would actually be a hope for breaking that because they won't be able to add to the supplies or like do. There's a lot of things they can't do that they can do with a central bank digital currency. So Bitcoin would be good in that scenario.
I have one penny of Bitcoin. Fingers crossed.
To the moon.
Yeah, I don't understand. Like if no one knows who the fuck Bitcoin, like who runs it or whatever, like some dude come out of the shadows and be like, yo, suck my cock. This is how much it's worth, Blobin.
You guys know John McAfee?
Yeah.
RIP.
Yeah, RIP goat. Crazy fucker. Used to have his women shit.
That was a hit piece on fucking piece. Showtime, dude. You Utah liberal.
No.
That's disgusting, dude.
No.
Get a booster. Get a booster before you say your next sentence.
I'm a big McAfee guy. Like, he actually got me interested.
And you believe that?
No, I believe McAfee.
You know, like, my brother had him on his podcast.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I swear to God.
I'm going to listen to that episode later. You're going to link me that later.
Yeah.
I love McAfee, dude. Like, I got into crypto because of McAfee. Like, I started learning about cybersecurity, blah, blah, blah. He started talking about crypto. I got more interested in crypto, so I stayed with that shit. But McAfee says he knows who Satoshi Nakamoto is, and he gave a name.
Who was it?
He claims... Fuck, gonna get murdered over this. He claims it was this guy named... It's not exciting at all. That's why it's kind of funny to say. But one of the people that it could be, who McAfee thinks it is a guy named Adam Back, who's like a UK-based cryptographer. Adam Back is his name. Just a high-tech guy. But the way the paper, the white... So when Bitcoin was released, they dropped a white paper. It's like a 10-page document, basically. And McAfee claimed that you can look at Adam Back's past writing when he was like a scholar or whatever. And you can like cross-reference the Bitcoin white paper to his like scholarly articles. And he's pretty sure it's him.
Now, did you follow the McAfee like whack shit? Like when he died, like, did you see any of that?
Yeah. So I didn't get into like the conspiratorial shit with it, but, or whatever facts we can call them. I don't know what I didn't get too deep into it now, but McAfee, when he was in Belize, according to him, so I don't know if the people know the story, but McAfee got rich. He moved to Belize. He bought like a house. When he got there, the Belizean government, which is a banana republic, was like, they knocked up on his door and they're like, yeah, McAfee, you got to give us $2 million. And he was like, no, get the fuck off my property. And they were like, they didn't like that answer whatsoever. So they came back. So like right after that happened, he started playing nice with them on purpose, and he gave the Belizean government workers brand new laptops, and they were like top of the line, like MacBooks, brand new. So they were like stoked to get these laptops because they had shit there in Belize. What they didn't know was he preloaded all those MacBooks with spyware, and then he repackaged them. So McAfee was in all the systems of the Belizean government.
Jesus Christ.
So he saw all the crazy shit they were doing. So like he had to, once they figured that out, they were trying to, he was a dead man walking, like they wanted his ass dead. So he had to go on the run because he figured out, according to McAfee, he claims that the head of immigration of Belize was actually the largest human trafficker in all of like Central America.
Holy shit.
And the head of like the drug agency of Belize was actually the largest like coke pusher in all of like Central America.
So. I mean, that shit makes complete sense.
Obviously. So yeah.
So it's the same shit in America. Like the DEA and the CIA, they all sell the fucking drugs and stuff.
Obviously. They just throw like the people in North Philly in jail, but fucking what's his name's digging tunnels out of the jailhouse twice.
Who, Chapo?
Chapo, yeah. R.I.P. Is he still alive?
He's still alive. He's in jail.
One of the goats, yep.
So you think the Belizean government killed McAfee?
When he went on the run from Belize, it's a crazy fucking story. Like, he was hiding in the rainforest. He had to like cross into Guatemala. He like faked a heart attack at one point when they captured him. He was dressing up as a woman. Like, he was doing crazy ass shit to try to escape. To try to escape these people, because yeah, dude, they wanted his ass dead. And then he remained on the run like all those years after. And then someone finally got him in jail. Yeah, he got killed without question. His wife says he got killed. She knows him the most. So I mean, who's there to believe?
Yeah, she was fucking heated when that shit happened.
Yeah. He wasn't suicidal according to her. So yeah, he got offed. When you see who's really pulling the strings and like the cartels and all that shit and the coke moving, like you're gonna get offed.
Yeah, that like what was his main, like, was he a big crypto guy or no?
He was, yeah. Bought Bitcoin really early. He was like a big advocate of like the privacy coins like Monero and Zcash, which have a level of an anonymity to them. When you send a transaction, they've got no clue who sent the transaction. So he was always big pushing those. He thought those were the future. But yeah, he was real involved in the crypto world. That was like his last hoorah in terms of like industries he got involved with.
What's that? Good.
That's it.
Yeah. What's the deal with the smart contracts? Like Pillow was trying to, or Giuliano was trying to explain how they work, but he said either you or the other kid knows how that actually goes. Like, what is the deal with these smart contracts? Like, how are they going to be better than just having a, like, a lawyer or whatever?
It's a long way out from, like, replacing the legal system, first of all, I would say, because, like, that's a big bureaucracy. Like, some code's not going to replace that anytime soon. But
well, what the fuck is it?
Yeah, so I'll try to give you, like, a layman's example. let's say there's $1,000 in escrow, meaning it's just sitting in an account, and you're supposed to receive it when like your brother dies or something. So like a smart contract could execute that transfer and then give you the $1,000 into your like crypto wallet at the right time. Or it's a way of doing like royalty payments for NFTs. So like each NFT that's sold on the aftermarket, one wallet address gets 10% of the sales. So like the smart contract executes that to make sure that in perpetuity, you always get that 10% on the aftermarket sales. So it automates some things that can make like efficiencies in the world, but real life.
Does it put it in the lawyers?
I mean, I would like to say yes, but I'm going to say no.
I feel like that you don't need a lawyer if that's the case. Like if everything's written up and it's like I just thought like, what the fuck's the point of having
for business law? Like, for business law, yeah, I would say you can get rid of a lot of work lawyers do.
Not for the shiesty stuff.
No, for
for Floyd.
No, definitely not. Okay. Like, for people like capping someone like on a Sunday, like you're gonna need those kind of lawyers still.
Yeah, yeah.
And the rest is on the Patreon. See you over there, bitch.